Yahoo! So I came in today, not necessarily with the question, but with an intent to play with all the questions that have been asked. And so there's been a few things that have came up, and I suppose I should go with what I was thinking of when I raised my hand. So I guess I'm going to start with our beliefs that create our vibration, wherever they may come from. They may be beliefs we are purposely trying to build for ourselves, or beliefs that may have been programmed or default from, you know, being raised in the environments we were raised in.
We have a question for you. Which do you think more reflects your experience around beliefs? Does it feel to you, knowing what you know and having observed what you've observed about your own life and maybe others, does it feel to you more like you got hold of a thought, doesn't matter who was promoting it to you, you considered it, it became active within you, maybe you witnessed others living something, and as you saw them living it, you observed it, and then you began offering a vibration. So does it feel to you like your beliefs that first came the observation, and then came the vibration, and then came the belief? Is the belief the byproduct of what you're observing? Or does it feel to you that you're choosing some belief that you want to foster and then focusing yourself into believing it?
I feel like it's a combination and evolvation from one to the other. And I guess my whole process behind this is an experience I recently had where I realized I had a belief I didn't even have, in which I had been operating on my whole life.
The reason that we wanted you to play with us, the reason that we wanted you to at least acknowledge which one of those feels like it's the most dominant in your experience, is because we want to talk for a moment about how beliefs happen, because beliefs are habits of thought. A belief is just a thought you continue to think. Why? Why do you continue to think it? Well, you continue to think it for a reason that you're not thinking of. You continue to think it because you're offering a vibration and law of attraction is matching it. And you're offering a vibration and law of attraction is matching it. And so it's sort of a cycle where you're observing what is, offering a vibration about it, and then getting more of what is. And so that's why things don't change for people very much, is because they observe and offer a vibration, and then law of attraction responds to their vibration and then confirms what they believe. So it's like the joke that Jerry used to tell Esther on a pretty regular basis, the man who complained about being sick all the time and then died, wanted it on his tombstone. See, I told you I was sick. You create your own reality.
It's like a vicious cycle here.
It's a wonderful cycle. It's a wonderful cycle of evolution. But when those like you begin to acknowledge that while law of attraction may have hold of you and your beliefs may be happening by default rather than by deliberate intent, that in the moment that you decide to care about how you feel, and in the moment you acknowledge that you have an inner being within you who also has an opinion or a perspective about what you are holding as your belief, then you have the capacity to evolve past what you've been observing. Then you break out of the cycle. Did you hear that? Then you break out of the cycle, because all through your building of beliefs, you know what you don't want, you know what you do want, you know what you don't want, you know what you do want, you know what you do want, you know what you do want. You don't move very much in your beliefs in that. You just keep asking for things you don't believe you can have. And then you ask harder for things you don't believe you can have. And then you ask harder for things you don't believe you can have. Or you ask softer for things that you believe you can have, and then you can have them. But you don't deviate far from your beliefs. But in all of that sifting and sorting and doing what you said you would do when you came into this physical body, you are creating, along with your inner being, a vibrational reality that is far more expansive than the reality that you stand in. Oh, whew. And your inner being stands, we mean that in a non-physical but very literal way, Your inner being, the larger part of you, stays focused inside of that vibrational reality that you have created, holding such focus to it that now the law of attraction is not just responding to what you believe, it's responding to what your inner being believes. And knowing is much more substantial than believing. So you're over here with beliefs because you keep observing it. Your inner being is over here with knowing. Knowing who you are, knowing your capacity, knowing your potential, knowing your worthiness, and knowing that you want this and this and this and this and this and this, right down to the minute detail. And understanding the laws of the universe, and so standing in full expectation of what you've asked for coming to be. Don't you want to let out a yahoo about that? Doesn't that feel exciting to you to know that? So now, what's logical now? Now that we've had that discussion, isn't it logical that you then begin to care how you feel so you can tell if you are in any moment under the influence of beliefs that may not be serving you, may or may not be serving you, or under the influence of your inner being who knows so much more? What influence do you want to be under? And so rather than talking about beliefs and trying to sort them out, let's put all of our emphasis on how do you feel? How do I feel? How do I feel now? How do I feel? Am I allowing myself to be under this influence, or am I guarding myself and demanding myself and punishing myself and disciplining myself to try to control the uncontrollable? Think about it. You can't not control the law of attraction. The law of attraction is responding to your vibration. So you certainly are part of the control, but when somebody sets out to control something, you almost always focus on what's wrong with the part that's wrong. At the same time, you're focused upon what's right with the part that's right. And then you introduce resistance into the equation and you just slow yourself way down. Your inner being is not ever doing that. Your inner being is focused only upon what you want and why you want it and seeing a clear path to the delicious and joyous and satisfying unfolding of it for you. Don't you like knowing that? And isn't this a good discussion about beliefs? So here are some questions for you. Would you rather in a moment in time be aware of your beliefs or in touch with your true knowing?
In touch with, yeah, your knowing and your feelings.
And is there a difference?
Yeah, big difference.
And is there any resistance in your true knowing?
No, unless you put it
there. And could there be resistance in your beliefs?
Yeah.
Are all of your beliefs resistant in nature?
Somewhat.
All of your beliefs are not resistant in nature, but your inner being is the only one who knows the difference. Because when you believe something, you're not a good witness. You're not a good witness. Do you know that? You can't be objective when you believe something. You can't move beyond what you believe. We have not had this discussion. Is it twisting your brain into a knot? Can you feel it though? Can you get what we're getting at?
Yes.
So when you allow yourself those glimpses into your vortex and those glimpses into your alignment, and then you focus from that point of view. So all that is required is that you accept that there are these steps and that you already did step one and that you filled your vortex full and that your vortex is answered and that's step two. And now, so what is step three? What is step three? Is step three about perusing your beliefs and sorting it out? No, that's step one. What's step three?
Allowing.
Step three is listening for the knowing of your inner being and putting yourself in a position to hear it. Yes?
Yeah.
This is a really good time for a segment of reflection.